Hi guys, and in this video today I'm going to be doing this look using the BH Cosmetics Galaxy Chic recording. Right, okay, I thought I was recording and it actually wasn't. Oh well. So what I said in the beginning is I'm going to do a makeup look using, hold on, let me put my beauty blender down, using the Galaxy Chic from BH Cosmetics, and all the eyeshadows in here are baked and it just looks like that. A lot of fun colours, to be honest, a lot of them are, you could easily wear, but yeah, my camera just, I didn't press the record button like an idiot. So all I've done so far is I've used the Avon Mesmerize Black for Him Aftershave Conditioning Balm because it has glycerine in it and it helps your makeup. So I've used that, and then I'm just bouncing in my face in my beauty blender at the moment, the Fit Me Maybelline New York Matte Poreless Normal to Oily Skin, which I'll just put a layer on that. I don't really like layering too much foundation stuff on my face, so that's that. And what I like to do now is everything's dirty because my powder miraculously decided that it would break everywhere. So let me just wipe this off. So for a concealer, I'm going to use my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, and this is in number 15. It has powder everywhere. Just watch that powder drip off. I'm just going to put this in like a triangular motion down my face. To be honest, I haven't actually found a concealer that actually works for me. To be honest, one that doesn't crack or go into my fine lines, but I'm hopeful I'll find one soon. Just gonna retake that beauty blender and bounce that into the skin. I think I need a hairband next time. Just bounce this all into the skin like so. Still recording it. It doesn't even look like I'm putting makeup on my face. Right, I've just got a cheapish powder that I'm just gonna buff into my skin just to make, I don't even know the make of it because it's come off. I'm having real trouble with my skin at the moment. Do you ever get that, like, your foundation just does not work? That is the way it's going at the moment. The lip back on this dark one, but can you see, like, I've got like hairs on your face. Does that just not irritate you? Because it irritates me so bad, because it just all, like, my foundation just shows. And I don't know, I need to find a foundation. So if anybody has a good foundation, and I think I've got dry skin, I think, or a concealer that will not sink into these fine lines, then please comment below and let me know, because I still have not found one that works well for me. So I don't know what I'm going to do. Girl problems here, hello. The next step, I'm just going to do my brows real quick. I'm going to do my brows real quick. However, I'm in one of those moods where I don't really want to do a lot to my brows today. So I'm just going to take the Makeup Academy Brow Define Tinted Brow Mascara, which if you watch my Superdrug haul, I did haul a lot of this Makeup Academy stuff, and it just has a small, what's that called now? Brush, but what is there a special word for it? No, I don't think it is. I'm thinking of lipstick and Adelpha. Idiot. And I'm just going to run this through my brows. Add a bit of colour, because I sort of want natural brows. It's a little bit hard to do this when I'm so far away from my mirror, but hopefully I don't do a bad job and it looks sort of alright. I'm hoping that you can hear me in this video, because I'm using my Samsung S1070 which I've had for ages, and I've just recently bought a memory card, but I'm hoping to get a tripod soon and some lights, because I'm sort of using the natural lighting, which just is doing nothing for this phone. But there you have it. I just love makeup. Well, if you saw my setup, let me show you. This is what we've got going on at the moment. Makeup, and then these are all my makeup's just full in that. But I haven't got nothing to put anything on, and I've put the mirror there. One, so I can see what I'm doing, even though I really want to do that. Blindfold makeup challenge, is it, or something, where you can't see, but I bet you all look like a mess. And I also want to do the 5-minute makeup challenge, because I can do my face literally like that if I have to. But then again, like, if I'm going out, like, I will do my face like perfecto, but on every day it's sort of like, and my skin's just playing up at the moment, but what am I gonna do? And hopefully it will stop being so dry. I have been trying to like moisturise as much as I can, but I just think I haven't found that perfect foundation or that perfect concealer yet that just suits my skin. Do you know what I mean? So it's one of those. But oh well, let's get back to it. So for bronzer, I'm just going to use, this is really hot, it's, well, the W7 makeup brush that I picked up. I think I picked it up for about £1. And this is what I use for my bronzer. And the bronzer I'm going to be using today is the Bajor. I can't say that. This is where I'm going to butcher this now. Bajor. Paris. Is that how you say it? I can't. I've butchered that completely. It is the Dulce de Powder Bronzing Powder filled with glints of sunshine. But that's it. I can't say words. I'm not very good. I'm just going to rub my brush in the powder, tap it off, and then just bronze my face. I'm not really feeling any blusher today, so I'm just gonna put it on like blusher just to give me a bit more of a bronzed face. When I go out, I do sometimes do my eyes first, just to, you know, my hair is popping in my head. So once we've done that, I'll put my brush back. This is improvisation to the fullest, right? I literally am using beer glasses, my makeup brushes, this is all my like face brushes, and then my eye brushes. I'm also using another beer glass. Bit of improvisation there. If you haven't got nothing to hold your brushes, use the beer glass. Works well. I am going to buy some like proper things, but at the minute a beer glass is all I can find. Well, that's how I'm holding my brush. It's a bit bad really, but oh well. Oh god, I have a hair off my brush on my face. My hair's down my head in. Right, oh no, wrong brush. Right, this I got with this. Did I? No, I didn't. I lied. Did I? No, I didn't. I got one similar to this and it came with a brush. It was off eBay. So no, it wasn't. It was off Amazon. I am not talking well today. What is going on? So, the highlight, it's very subtle. It ain't bam bam thank you ma'am in your face. But it's a little highlight. So I'm using the Makeup Academy Undress Your Skin Shimmer Highlight, if I can get it open, and it just looks like so. So I'm just going to swirl my brush in this powder, tap it off, then I like to put it on my nose and on the tip of my nose. Excuse me, can you see the shine on my nose or not really? No, probably not, because the lighting ain't very good. Swirl it in, and then I'm just going to apply this to the top of my cheek. Like, so. To be honest, I want like a smaller brush to do this, but can you even see that highlight? Probably not. So really, that, apart from eyes and lips, that is everything I'm going to do for my face. So the Maiden Step known as Take the Galaxy's Cheek 18 Colour Baked Eyeshadow Palette. And this is what it looks like. And they're just amazing. Like, let me just swatch a couple for you. Like, look at those. Like, hello. How pigmented are those? Like, I love BH Cosmetics so much. So to start off with, I'm going to just take this brush that I got from, I got a pack of them from Amazon, and we're going to start off, because I want to do a bit of a red eye, we're going to start off with, no, oh god, here we go, I'm going to butcher these eye colours so much, I don't know, planets. Aphrodite, which is this red colour here, if you can see, I don't know if you can, because I can't see myself. I'm just going to tap off the excess, and then you're literally going to just put work this on the outer corner. Like so. And then once you've got it on your outer corner, you're then going to just sweep, like window sweep motions, into the crease. I'm no way a makeup artist, so if you don't like this makeup look, then I'm sorry. But this is just one way that I do my makeup, and I like to do both eyes at the same time because that's just who I am. But yeah, I'm not a makeup artist. I'd love to get my makeup done by a makeup artist, wouldn't we all? Like, for everyday purposes, I'm just, you know, putting this on my eye. But, you know, if I was going out to town or to a restaurant, I'd have tape and I'd make sure it's, like, on point. But as it's just, like, this everyday makeup look, I'm just going to go with the flow. And I'm just going to take this other one and just make sure this is blended into my skin. And I've just mucked up my brow. Probably should have done my brows last. Just blend that into the skin. And then I'm going to take the same brush again, because everyone says the dirty brushes, I don't. So I'm going to go into Mars. I can say that one because it's easy, right? Mars. Instead of some of these, like Pomphius. And I'm just going to dip my brush in. Tap off the exit. I just put that on the mirror, idiot. And then I'm just going to work this into the outer V again, just to give a bit more definition. And then just swipe the excess on the brush. I'm not very good at this talking, am I, on a camera? I think I get really nervous. But it's because I don't even know, do you know when you don't even know if it's going to pick up your sound? And you're just like, blah 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 blah. But there's enough of sound coming out, I have that feeling that that's going to happen to me. My eyelashes are really irritating me today. Put that on the outer again, and window swipe in. Like, literally, this makeup look is like a go-to for me, because I can normally do my makeup really quick. So that is the look at the moment. And then, I don't know whether I want to add like a bit of like a purple plummy colour. So I'm going to take Pluto, which reminds me of that Pluto the dog. Is that in Mickey Mouse? I don't even know. So, just swirl your brush, get some product on that. And now let's see if this works. This can either go wrong or right. And I'm going to just place this right on the outer corner. And just work it in. Can you see what I'm doing? I need to be able to see, this is still recording, right? Yeah. I'll zoom you in a sec to see not always once they're complete, but it's sort of so that is the eyes. The minute I'm taking that same brush, which these ones I did get off eBay, I think there was like, you got four of these and then four face brushes for I think like a fiver, which weren't so bad. Just make sure all this burns. Right, so to go on, let me put these brushes back for a second. So to go on the inner portion of my eye, oh god, this is the, I'm going to take Prometheus, which is that colour there, and I'm just going to take that on basic finger, make sure I've got nothing on it, just swirl it in there, and then just literally pop that on the eye, like so. Oh, just put my finger in the wrong colour. That would have been embarrassing, wouldn't it? So it looks like so. And then to go on this inner corner of my eye to try and brighten up my eye, I'm going to take Meter mixed with a bit of Milky Way, which are these two colours here. I really don't know whether you've seen this because I can't actually see myself. And I'm just going to pump that on the inner part of my eye. Like so. And then the last step, looking for my beer coloured brushes, I am going to take this flat head brush, which come in the set as well, and I'm just going to repeat the steps on the outer underneath my eye. Let me pull this off. I've had these ages and like still had the sticker on the mirror. You can actually see properly. So we're going to dip our brush back into Aphrodite, tap off the axis, and we're just going to drag this underneath the eye like so. And we're going to do that on exactly the other side. Maybe pop my off in the eye. And then next is to dip our brush into Mars. Tap off the excess. Oh, blocking the camera. And go underneath. Same with this side. And last but not least, dip it back into Pluto, which is here. Tap off the excess. It's like a purpley plummy colour. Put that underneath the eye. Like so. And that is the eyes now complete. It is, like, you can do this look really, the word, like, really quick, but I'll just, you know, take my time. And the last step to the eyes is mascara, so I'm going to take the Avon Big and Multiplied Volume Mascara. Sometimes this makes my eyes sting and I don't quite understand why. It's, I don't know whether I get it in my eye or what, but it just stings like real bad. My hair's going for a bit of a change. I'm deciding to let the dye grow out as you do, so it looks a bit mad at the moment. So this is what the brush looks like. It's quite big and bulky. We're just going to apply this to our lashes, and then once we've applied it to our lashes, I'll zoom you in and show you the finished look. That's just my phone ringing. I don't know who it is. It's it's an unknown caller, so I'm not going to answer that. And just go around again. Add a bit more volume to your lashes. And a bit more length. And then we'll do the bottom lashes as well. But I'll do that with a different mascara. One that's a bit more... I've got a thinner brush, but I'll just have to find it. Most of my makeup is in my drawers, but then I have this one bag which is like my everyday makeup sort of bag. So I'm going to use, for my bottom lashes, the number 7 Dramatic Lift for the Ultimate Wide Awake look, which my work colleague got me for Christmas, and it came in a little set. And this is what it looks like. It's just a little bit of a smaller brush. Probably still get it all over my face. I'll keep doing it. Now I'm getting my hair. Don't you just hate it when your hair just goes in your mascara? And you just have black streaks. It's a different day. I've gone to edit my video and I've realised that the ending didn't actually record. So I've redone my makeup again. And I'm just gonna finish where it left off. So that is the finished eye look. So the last thing to do for this look is the lips, and for this look I'm going to be applying the Makeup Academy matte lipstick in Born Fancy to my bottom lips. I want to keep it quite nude because the eyes are red and purple. But this is the finished look. Thank you all for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you have enjoyed it. And if you're new to my channel, I am JD, so please don't forget to subscribe and look out for my next video. Thank you. Bye.